Good evening. My name is Mackenzie King, and it gives me great pleasure to welcome you to our spring piano recital. On behalf of our principal, Dr. Danielle Mosley, and our entire William J. Clark family, we express sentiments of gratitude for your presence this day. We ask that you sit back and enjoy the musical selections that my peers and I have prepared for your listening pleasure. This evening's program includes multiple genres of music that we have studied throughout this term. Compositions from Bach, Beethoven, Vivaldi, to Snoop Dogg, and even Dr. Dre. With this in mind, we thank you for your presence, and we again hope that you enjoy our program. Again, welcome.
Spirituals, also known as Negro spirituals, African-American spirituals, Black spirituals, and spiritual music is a genre of Christian music that is associated with Black American, which merges Sumerian African cultural heritage with the experience of being held in bondage to slavery. At first, during the transatlantic slave trade, and for centuries afterwards, due to domestic slave trade, spirituals and conflicts, the sing songs, work songs, and plantation songs that evolved into the blues that often called the church. In the 19th century, the word spirituals referred to all these subcategories of folk songs. While they were often rooted in political stories, they also described the extreme hardships endured by African Americans who were enslaved from the 17th century until the 18th century. The emancipation offering mainly the nature, but not continuation of slavery for many. University of Denver professor Arthur Jones, who established the Spirituals Project in 1998 out of the University of Glenmore School of Music, described how poetic words could be introduced into college and responsible for that, with only insights of words that encrypted message but understand. He described already existing spirituals were employed clandestinely as one of many ways people in their multi-layered struggle for freedom. This evening, my peers will perform spirituals for you that were also classified as work songs that encompass the call response feature. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome my peers performing Kumbaya and Standing in Need of Prayer.
The blues form is ubiquitous in jazz, rhythm and blues, and rock and roll, and is characterized by the color response pattern, the blues scale, and specific chord progressions, of which the 12-bar blues is the most common. Blue notes or worried notes, using thirds, fifths, or sevenths, flattening pitch, are also an essential part of the sound. Blues shuffles or walking bass reinforce the trance-like rhythm and form a repetitive effect known as the groove. Blues as a genre is also characterized by its lyrics, bass lines, and instrumentation. Early traditional blues verses consisted of a single line repeated four times. These next compositions will encompass the 12-bar blues formula. A 12-bar blues progression is a set chord progression that repeats every 12 bars of music. You'll play the one chord for four measures, the four chord for two measures, the one chord for two measures, the five chord for one measure, the four chord for one measure, and the one chord for one measure, then the five chord for the last measure. Please welcome our pianist performing Got Those Blues and Bluesy Riff.
This next composition, we're going to kind of improvise for you a little bit. This is something that we did in class one day when we were studying our blues unit. We kind of had some activities on making up songs using the blues formula. Malachi just shared with you the blues formula of the one chord, the five chord, the four, and so on. So what we want you to be able to do is to be able to tell when these chord changes happen. So we're going to do an impromptu performance. We call it a bluesy riff that we made up one day. And we're going to see if we can do it today. All right.
Thank you. Congratulations, you all, and this was a wonderful program, and we have one more selection.